In observance of National Maritime Day, local and military officials, along with members of the maritime community, gathered to honor the nation's merchant mariners and seafarers in Guam May 22nd. The day's events began with a proclamation signing by Guam Governor Lulian Guerrero at the Ricardo J. Bordalio Governor's Complex in Hagatnya, where those in attendance acknowledged the sacrifice and dedication of merchant, civilian, and contract mariners who contribute their time and talent to the nation's commercial and military operations. They also recognized those who have lost their lives doing so. Later in the day, local and military officials, along with Coast Guardsmen and sailors, boarded U.S. Coast Guard cutter Kiska and set out of Apra Harbor for a wreath-laying ceremony at sea. Commander Ted Huebner, commanding officer of Military Sealift Command Ship Support Unit Guam, regarded merchant mariners as the nation's fourth arm of defense and one of the most dangerous military professions, especially during times of war. Further, he recognized mariners as the lifeblood of the economy in both Guam and the U.S. mainland.
I think a lot of Americans in general forget the sacrifices merchant mariners have made over the years. They're known as, you know, the nation's fourth arm of defense by people who pay attention to these things. But what a lot of folks don't realize is how many merchant mariners we've lost over the years. And they're great Americans doing great things for the country, both inside Military Sealift Command and the, you know, naval side of things, and also in the rest of the world. They deserve to be recognized.
In 1933, members of the U.S. Congress signed a joint resolution designating May 22nd of each year as National Maritime Day in commemoration of the first transoceanic voyage by the American steamship SS Savannah in 1819. For Joint Region Marianas, I'm Alana Charguloff.